Hello students, this video is for class 11 science and today I am going to continue with the botany chapter that I have started with your class, that is science of life. So let's start with the botany part, or the part which is remaining, the science of life. In my previous video I have done till the three characteristics of the living things. Now after that we will start. So we will continue with the characteristics of the living things. So number four, that means fourth characteristic, is movement and locomotion. See, we all know that the living things are the ones who are capable of free movement and locomotion. That can be of the movement of the amoeba, movement of the plant organs, locomotion from one place to another. All these are the characteristics of the living world. Movement means the, you already know these terms though I am repeating it. Movement means the movement of certain body parts from one place to another. It does not involve the change of position of the body. Locomotion means obviously it involves the change of position of body from one place to another. Apart from this, in order to change the place or location of the body, they need to move their body parts. So locomotion is associated with movement, movement is associated with locomotion, but in order to perform movement, locomotion is not essentially necessary. Now we know generally there are various types of movements are there. First movement is amoeboid movement. We have read it in class 10 also, this one, this amoeboid movement. We know that the amoeba doesn't have any locomotory organ, particular locomotory organ. The generally its body reshapes or take a structure and forms a locomotory organ, temporary locomotory organ, which we call it as pseudopodia, right? Here pseudo means false and podia means foot. So what happens in case of amoeboid movement, we know that the amoeba is very irregular in shape. So this cytoplasm of the amoeba creates some finger-like projections and helps the amoeba to move forward. This is the pseudopodia, the false foot. So this is amoeboid movement. Apart from this, we can also see some movements in plants like syzmonastic movement, chemonastic movement, nictinastic movement. So these types of movement and locomotion is categorized under this, or given as an example under it. Like the movement in case of us, that is bipedal movement, it is also an example under the movement and locomotion. Bipedal, bi means two, pedal means foot, the locomotion involving two foot. Like the locomotion in by the help of cilia, flagella, this is also categorized under movement and locomotion. So these are the various types of movement and locomotion. So fourth point is done. Now moving to our fifth point, which is metabolism. Now what is metabolism? What is it? Metabolism is that sum total of biochemical changes involved in the two-fold process of waste and repair of the protoplasm is known as metabolism. Metabolism actually means change. That means we are intaking the food, we are wasting our energy. So in between this, there are certain changes that are taking place in our body. That is regarded as the metabolism. Now it is having two parts, anabolism and catabolism. Now anabolism means the constructive process, like nutrition or the taking in of food, not properly nutrition. Nutrition is partly anabolic, partly catabolic. Ingestion is anabolic in nature, whereas catabolic will be like excretion, that is a part type of catabolic function. So catabolism means destructive process, anabolism means constructive process, the one who is helping in the building of the protoplasm. And catabolism means which is wasting or which is spending the energy, like respiration. Understood? So these are the two parts of metabolism which continuously maintaining the metabolism. Now the number 6 part is nutrition. Now let us see what is nutrition. Now nutrition, it is a process by which different types of nutrients, food or essential substances are being absorbed in our body. So this nutrition is again divided into 5 steps. First one is ingestion. Ingestion means intake of food or taking in of food through the mouth. Clear? After taking it, the next part is digestion. Digestion means here the food is going into the stomach and it is being digested or being broken down to simple forms. Third part, absorption. After the stomach region, it reaches the small intestine where partly digestion goes on. Apart from this, mainly the inner layer of the small intestine produces finger-like projections that we call villi. Now these villi increases the surface area of the small intestine and helps in the absorption of food materials or the nutrients which are broken down as a from a complex food. Now fourth one after absorption is assimilation. Now after being absorbed in the villi, the blood cells will take the food from there and will circulate it in the entire body. Whichever body part is lacking any nutrition, that region or in that region, those particular nutrients which are absent over that region will get assimilated. This is the process of assimilation. Fifth one is egestion. Egestion means removal of the waste substances. That means the things or the food particles which cannot be digested further, those are regarded as the waste substances and it should not be carried in the body. It should be eliminated out from the body. That is regarded as the egestion. So these are the 5 steps of nutrition. So I am completing my video over here. In the next video, I will continue with the next part of the chapter. Thank you.